So they came in the room, and they didn't start doing anything until the 27 pages, whether or not to slow it down, the giving us the machine to do that. So they decided to take that. And the guy who came in, and he said, "Can you use your name?" I said, "Oh, no, I can't." I tried to do it. I said, "No, I can't, please don't make me." I said, "Okay." I don't know if it's going to take it off, I don't care if it was me, but there was just another one that was going to be. And, so they put me to sleep, I feel like, you know, they did some death or something, but no. And then I was in surgery for about 4 hours, I think, maybe 4 hours to take it off. They had to disconnect the take it off, because that was, that bone didn't break, and if that bone would have broke, it would have come off of the washer, it would have been horrible, it wouldn't have been and so, they put me on there, they took it off, and before they put me on there, I had no idea what was going to be in this time, but they really didn't know what was going on, they didn't know what to expect. And I woke up the other day, Sunday, this first of the month. Remembered what had happened, and I came out of my mouth. And I don't understand, and there was a nurse in there cleaning the floor. And I had also bruised my arm, and she just said, "Well, shut up and get to sleep." And then a nurse was to me. So I was in the hospital, I was supposed to be in the hospital for a good 2 weeks, but I was really not prepared, and so I got out of my room, and I got very sick. The next day, my parents flew in with a friend's office, so they asked me what I wanted. And so I told them everything that I wanted, and I wanted the unit of food, more, school beer more than anything else in the world, so they got me one. They got me one that's so big. I got everything you can imagine. That was right before Christmas. And then after the news, I got to go home. And people still come over all the time and got me gifts and stuff. And then I stopped the money for it and I just came out of it. And the dean told me that I was going to be married. I thought it was something to do, something specific, but I thought, well, at first, I thought it was real bad. And then I told him, "No, I've never been to town forever." And then I told him, "Well, yeah, I'm living good. I'm still there. It's still here." Maybe you're wondering, you know, what this stuff looks like and what it feels like. They saved as much as they could. So they took it out of the elbow. I've got part of the joint on here. And here's my stair. I have 500 stitches, and then it came off. I said, "Ouch, I have 30 stitches." But I have only got a spot for it. And it's, the scale has to be on. And it feels like a long ride. It's kind of good for it. It's funny, because everybody's spot looks the same. They must be different. But there was a, it's, even with this nothing stuff, I think it could be like it. It's right here, it's kept up. They filled it out, but they put it in the front, so it ain't got much muscle in this one. Not too much. because of this point of view. I think very much it's like I do the rest of my body. And I think how I can run motion at it so that I don't have to watch this time. It's like from my elbow here on up to not here, but you know, never get flushed enough and that part of it didn't get it down. Yeah, but so far. Personally, it's something that feels kind of like stitching in the face. Is that my body's gone? It's really kind of good. And, you know, I threw them. I had the stitches out when I got home. And I set the balance stick out. And I fell down and just took it all out of it. So I had to go back and get stitches put back in the meantime. So through all that again. I hope you can enjoy a little chit chat here, and I want to thank you for opening my tapes and my photos, and if you do have any other requests, send them to my friend Sue, and she'll let me know, and I'll get on it, and do some more videoing, and more pictures, and we'll get them up to you, and I appreciate yours. Thank you.